Thank you, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you have a good day. I have been a hassle reaching Niagara Falls. I arrived at JFK on Friday, but they canceled all the evening flight. So I booked a Sheraton hotel on Friday, but I cannot come here, though I need to search for a hotel. And all the hotels around the airport are fully booked because they canceled a lot of flights that day. I think a very bad weather. So I need to search for a hotel. I take a cab and go from one hotel to the other hotel. I reached 164th Street and I managed to get one room. They rebooked me on Saturday, 5:30 p.m. and early at the airport at 3 o'clock. You know, they fly from JFK to Buffalo almost 9 o'clock at night. So it was very hassle, but when we reached, when I reached Niagara Falls, I think it's worth the journey. It's worth the journey and looking at the waterfalls. I was there yesterday and I took this photo and made it as my first slide that we can share together. Very interesting, very nice weather yesterday, so I enjoyed my stay. I'm alone. That's my name. The first name is my name, Saleh Abdul Rashid. In English, or Saleh means Simon, and Rashid is Richmond. It goes the same. So it's difficult for you to pronounce my name as Saleh. You can pronounce as Simon if you want. Literary meanings, literal meanings. So the second name is my VC, so I will present him. And the others are my colleagues. I'm from University of Malaysia, Perlis, the northern state of Malaysia. So we have 13 states, and mine is on the top, very small state, beside the border of Thailand. So you can cross Hat Yai by driving just less than 30 minutes. So I always be Hat Yai, I think very popular to you all. And we're very near to Pulau Langkawi, or Langkawi Islands in Malaysia. It's a very nice island. One of the top 10 in the world, I think so. So that's my email address, and I will show you a bit of our website afterwards. We are more focusing on, we are really a focused university. UNIMAP, we call it UNIMAP because it's an acronym for University of Malaysia Perlis. So Uni is University, M is MA is Malaysia, P is Perlis, so we call it UNIMAP. So University with a map in the world. So we're very new, we're only about 9 years old. So we have a capacity now about less than 7,000 students. We are really focusing on engineering. So we have 21 programs in engineering, and our niche area is microelectronics. But I'm not an engineer, I'm not teaching any engineering program or engineering subject. I'm at the School of Communication and Entrepreneurship. So my school are more taking care of the soft skill of the student. So when the first presenter just now mentioned about cultural, cross-cultural, so it's really related to my school, my faculty. So can we start? So my topic is about promoting international partnership in the academia towards international visibility. Practiced by newcomers, meaning by me, by us. We are very new. I think some of the universities in US and Canada, or maybe some of your university are 100 years. Even my colleague from University Utara, the Northern University of Malaysia, is almost 50 years, is it? 25 years. So we have 20 public universities in Malaysia, and my university is number 70. We were formed in 2002, that year. So I'm just joining it from the other university. Actually, I'm formerly from University Malaysia Sabah on the Borneo part. So Malaysia is divided into two, the West and the East. East Malaysia and West Malaysia. So I've already given my service in the West and the East Coast. On the East, the West Malaysia is where we are now. Okay? So actually, the university sent me to learn something from the conference. I don't know whether my university is a member of the ASAHIL committee. But I believe so because the VC asked me to join in. So maybe I want to learn more from you rather than you learn from me. Okay, as a university. Right. That is our logo. It's more on the engineering part, something like school, whatever. So actually, we don't have a main campus. We are more scattered. I show you my my type. So that is our website. That is our main campus. We have about 13 locations distributed around the state. Some sort like Imperial College of London, they have different locations, right? So we also have different location for different faculty. We are not situated at one place. So we are contacted by IT. Alright, that is our website. I think there's a few conferences. So if you look at the conference, we are really focusing on engineering, engineering science, biomedical engineering, man and machine, something to do with engineering. Right, so we are very focused. You see, this is our VC that had the distinguished fellowship with Auckland University of Technology in Ireland recently, I think last week. So we call it distributed campus throughout Sydney, place. Okay, just an introduction for my university. I think we go back to the presentation. So I think I begin with. When we come to this word we mentioned this morning, that we are caught by the rating and ranking of the universities. And even in Malaysia, it's some sort like, I don't know, it's something like what everybody is trying to do with numbers. Numbers, how many publications you have done, how many research, how many amount of grant that you have already get from the other parties or the other overseas. So as a newcomers, as a newcomers, I think we are also caught in that situation. We are trying to not to say like challenges or what we call it, but it's more like a blue ocean strategy. We are lucky because in Malaysia there's only a few universities that really focus on engineering. Most of our universities are full-fledged universities. They're offering a lot of programs. But we only have four that really focus on engineering. We call it Malaysian Technical University. So one of it is ASLA. We have 20 just now, but we have a lot of private universities. So whether you like it or not, by hook or by crook, I think we have to have this international cooperation. By most universities around the group for similar objectives are related to international recognition and benefit, which includes profit, prestige, and strategic alliance. You know, with the teams, red team, with the scopus, with the radiometric and everything, whether we want it or not, we have to compete. So for us as a newcomers, the turf is tougher, especially when the core players already international, way forward comparing to us. So we try to learn from others actually. So I think in this presentation, in the short presentation, I will take you less than 10 minutes. I only have 10 slides, don't worry. I've got less than 10 slides. To discuss the action taken in promoting international partnership that been played by university like us, that we call it UNIMED from Malaysia. And we try to share the practice and experience of other universities as to give a view of the common challenges faced by the newcomers. I'd just like to quote what we mentioned by our first distinguished speaker just now. You know, in Malaysia, we have different ethnic groups. Even in one state, in Sabah, for example, in Borneo, we have 35 ethnic groups. And the major groups in West Malaysia, we have the Malaysian, the Chinese, and the Indian. It's a long history about this migration and citizenship. The matter is, in public universities, most of the enrollment of the students are the Malays, because it's sponsored by the government. And most of the private universities have been merged in the major towns area in Malaysia. And most of the intakes is Chinese. So when we're talking about cross-cultural barriers and bridging the human being, I think in our university we have one subject where we call it as ethnic relationship. But when we say about internal relationships, the major enrollment in that particular public university is Malays. So we learn about internet relationship, but we learn among us. That's a difficulty to what we call about transnational. It's not even to trans between the university, also it's a bit difficult, right? So that's the challenges, I think, ahead. So I think the focus of we as a newcomers is trying to establish a strategic alliance with a more established university. will show you a graph afterward how many MOU, MOA, and strategic alliance have been done by our universities, like we mentioned by our president just now. It's just on paper. Haven't materialized it on what in doing just MOU, where we need to further hands with some other practical alliance. So we identify local partners. University or University of Utara Malaysia or the Northern University of Malaysia is part of our local partners. They are full-fledged university. They have a lot of program compared to us. We are discovering potential opportunities and maintaining established networks through scheduled communication and utilizing the providence with development of the international affair in view. And last but not least is bright insight in the future, most planned by UNIMAPS, by us, towards further international visibility. We have the aims, by 2020 we try to be the top 500 universities. That is our aim, not right now. Our strategic planning, we're going towards to be international visibility to be among the top 500 universities in the world, especially on engineering programs. That is our aim. So what I have done is looking at what Carson has said, that I try to get some benchmark and measures to promote international visibility. And Carson mentioned about these four things, that study by students from other countries and their own national in other countries. For example, we have about 150 international students, mostly from the Middle East and the Chinese, from China. And we have difficulties about this communication with the Chinese student. Even we have before the 6-month, what we call it, intensive English courses, but 6 months I think is not enough to them. Most of them have a pointer very low, 2-point-something, a few. And we have some from Mauritius, Iraq, Libya, Timor, the Middle East, a few from, I think one or two from European countries. Study, teaching or research by academic staff in other countries by foreign national in their own universities. The third one is research or development project conducted in cooperation with universities. And recently we have a very good grant from Saudi Arabian University, what we call it. Saudi Arabia's College of Arts and Technology, they give us $1.5 million to do something on green technologies, research on green technologies. That's a good initiative that's been done by our university. As a new university, we get $1.5 million from them. I think this Middle East country, that we can do something for them, they have a lot of money. Maybe they can give us some good grant. And the fourth one is a validation of academic or management standard by comparison with universities of other countries. That we try to do. We try to benchmark ourselves with the more established universities. For your information, most of our staff, we now have about 27% of our staff that are having a PhD. To be a research university, what we call it, we need at least 70% of our staff to hold a PhD. So far, we are lag behind, we only have 37%. And most of our staff doing our PhD is either in the UK, in Germany. I think less and less people from Malaysia are coming to US, I don't know why. Normally, when you say about going postgraduate studies, the Malaysia will go to the US or UK. But now, it's getting less and less. I don't know why. Maybe we have to do some research about that. Okay, they go to Australia. And Japan, because of the engineering base. So less and less is going to UK now because of the tuition fees is quite high now. So compared to Australia and New Zealand, some is going to Japan, right? So this is a learning from others. We try to share our resources such as academic staff, teaching, learning facilities, and research equipment and ideas. For example, at our faculty, we are offering some language courses, and we try to, let's say we offer Japanese, we try to get a Japanese to teach Japanese. We have Mandarin, we get the Chinese lecturers from China. We have Germany, we get someone from German. And we are trying to offer as many foreign languages as we could. But to get the mother tongue speakers is a bit difficult. Not many people willing to come to Malaysia because our pay are very low. One-to-one is okay. Like about a tin of Coke here is about what, $3. Down there is almost 10 ringgit. So it's 1-to-1 is cheap, but when we calculate by multiplying with our money, our ringgit are not that big. we are $1 to $3, $1 equivalent to $3 US. Okay. Sharing of name and experience amongst academics. We try to appoint a young professor from other universities. For example, we do it with Bohemia, I can't remember, in Czech Republic. So by using his name, and when he publish any paper, he put our name in his paper. Although he's not situated in Malaysia, he is in Czech Republic, but when he publish a paper, he will put our name. So when the scopus cite our name, so we got about 21 papers from him. So our scopus become higher and higher. That's why we do establish the sharing of name and experience among the academicians. So they are not working with us, but with some sort like giving him a grant, or he come for twice a year for professional talks and all that. But any paper published, they put our name in, UniMed. So Scopus will catch the name, and we get some numbers, some increase of numbers. When we talk about Scopus, they want numbers of publication and citation index. So how do we do with the number two, sir? Providing enrichment and diversity among the students, we try to do some collaboration and MOU with some other university. As a new university, not many universities willing to do some MOU with us. So we try to penetrate the Middle Asia university, for example, in Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, we have some MOU with them. And we have some cultural exchanging between the students. So the students coming to give some cultural show to us, we send our students to be there. So that's how we promote our collaboration for the number two. Number four, becoming a platform for quality improvements among the staff. I think that's okay. Capturing from everything common time. Making the most of economic circumstances and religious and multi-ethnic harmony. I think most of you well known about Malaysia multi-ethnic community and races, but we're still okay. We're still okay. So far. This is a numbers of MOU, numbers of country, and the graph is going up. From 2007 to 2010, from 20 MOU, we already come up to almost 70. Now we are already more selective. Last time, any university, any small university will do the MOU with us. But now the VC asks us to get a more selective university, well-known university. Recently, I had to work out with Imperial College of London and University, Cairo University. So we tried to get the biggest players compared to the smaller one recently. And the numbers of country, I think we already go up to 30 now. Most are the Europe, Middle East, and Japan and Korea. Okay. And I think it's the number three is addition. When we are voting years, about 10 years now, we are more selective. So the additional become less and less. But the country increase and the numbers of you also increase. Try to promote ourselves in the playing US. The challenges that we face is our location. Like I showed you the map, because now we are more toward the north. So not many people are willing to come to Perlis. It's the northern state of Malaysia. It takes about 1.5 hours flight from Kuala Lumpur. The major university in Malaysia is situated in Kuala Lumpur, University of Malaya, the first university and all that. So we are more on toward the north, a very small town, I think like Niagara Falls. So not many people willing to come to us. So we have to getting the either the MOU or the international visibility because of our location. Okay? I think the second challenge is depends on the alliance for skill is a major problem. Thus, our university does lack to a certain extent as a prominent scholar and communication in certain areas of expertise. I think that's is the biggest task to us. And sometimes the interest differs or contracting from what we want because we really a focused university. So most of our, university are more established. They are full-fledged, they have a faculty of engineering, they really focus on engineering. Okay? And three most challenging. Challenge is great, unequal gains, differences in cultural values, and role in BT, I think is already in my papers. Dr. Frank already stand beside me. Give me 1 minute, please. And last but not least, another two slides. Like been mentioned by our first speaker just now, is to increase their added values. We can produce a good engineers, but if a good engineer doesn't come to work or always applying for an MC, it's not good. But they cannot communicate, because the major research found in Malaysia that we can produce engineers, but we cannot find engineers that can really communicate in such a way. And now recently there are two types of engineering studies in Malaysia. The government are moving towards more to the engineering technology rather than the conventional engineering. And this is something to do with the accreditation of the world. So by doing this MOU or by this international visibility will help us to build up a better program and curriculum, boost our teaching and learning, improvements in terms of benchmarking and ensure the quality of technology program. Research and development, I think all this is okay. I think the last one is a good point. Induced collaboration with local industry, I think as so with the others industry, because Malaysia is not really an industrial country. We're just moving towards that. Maybe by sending our students doing the industrial training outside should be better. Right? Okay, I think that's it. Thank you very much.
Open it up for a couple of questions. If anybody's got any questions.
Anything?
Go ahead.
Just quickly, you are a technological institution.
Yes.
Have you thought about, and you're saying that place is a problem for you, your location, it's difficult to bring. Are you using technology at all? Are you using online connections for sharing classes with other institutions, sharing research with other institutions?
Yes, that's what we are trying to do. Exactly in Malaysia, when we learn through, we need to do some what we call it face-to-face connection. We like to be in the lectures hall. We need like to be to contact with the particular lecturers and all that. I think there is one university in Malaysia, we call it Open University of Malaysia, that's offering this distance learning by this module learning or by not be in contact with the lecturers. You just stay at home, or you go to a certain center to do some, you know, for having your lectures. But it seems that it's been we call it undervalued. You know, when you get your certificate or you get your cert, they consider, we in Malaysia consider that is a second tier of qualification. Although it's equivalent to a degree, but it's a second tier of a degree. Maybe the mentality is still not there, right? The other part, when I say the location, even this map shows that the red colors come out, meaning they want to change to campus. We in Malaysia, we like to study in such what we call it, one compound, that we share everything there, the library there, everything is there. But when this UNIMED have a concept of this distributed campus, most of the students put a comment on our suggestion board. They don't like the way we are organizing the lectures, because they have to move from one side to the other and all that. They don't like it, you know, because you know, in Malaysia, we have 32 to 35 degrees of Celsius throughout the year, so they have to move around. I think it's very nice to them. I think we like your suggestion. We try to do that. Even we communicate through our portal, so the student complain, even the lecture not been uploaded using our internet. But I think the culture is still not there, or is still, you know, we are still learning, we are still doing our best to accommodate everything.
Certainly open up some possibilities for you, and they're already doing
face-to-face. Yes, I agree with you. And the other difficulty is about engineering program, we need a lab. You know, they use a lot of like the cleaning room, everything. So by distance learning, by using IT, I think it's a bit difficult. They need to be in the campus to handle all the things by hands-on. That's a bit difficult thing about distance learning and hands-on experience on engineering. Okay?
Time for one more quick question, if I may have. Please help me in thanking Professor Rashid for his presentation.